There has been a lot of talk about the potential for a divorce between Kanye West and Kim Kardashian, because ever since the beginning of the year, the two have had quotes, interviews, social media posts, and more that said they were, they weren't, or that they could get a divorce.
Right now, our GMA cover story, Kim Kardashian has filed for divorce from Kanye West after nearly 7 years of marriage.
But now, finally, the confirmation has come, and Kim Kardashian has filed for divorce from Kanye. But what does this all mean in the grand scale? How will everything go down in terms of the custody battle, and so on? I'm gonna break it down for you, but first, do me a favor, be sure to leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel. Now let's get started. Do you wanna win an iPhone 12? Maybe a MacBook Pro? How about $500 cash? All you have to do is comment the secret hidden message somewhere in this video. That's it. Oh, and leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel so we can keep affording these giveaways. Winner will be announced at the last day of each month. Thanks for watching and good luck. Number 6, the divorce is happening. Let's get right to the facts. After months of speculation about the hows and the whens and the who gets what elements, we can confirm that Kim Kardashian has officially filed for divorce from now ex-husband Kanye West. Kim is asking for joint legal and physical custody of the couple's 4 kids.
Kanye, can you look to the corner?
After almost 7 years of marriage, Kimye is no more. On Friday, Kim Kardashian filing for divorce from 43-year-old rapper Kanye West.
Sources with direct knowledge tell TMZ Kanye is fine with a joint custody arrangement, and we're told both Kim and Ye are committed to co-parenting together. More on that later. There is a prenup, and we're told neither party is contesting it. In fact, sources say they are already far along in reaching a property settlement agreement. The docs, filed by Disso Queen Laurel Weiser, don't list the date of separation. It's listed as to be determined. The date is almost irrelevant because their split has been so well chronicled in the news and social media, as you might remember. If you recall certain reports, this is a big change from what some thought would happen.
Kanye believes it was his ill-fated 2020 presidential run that was the tipping point, saying it was the straw that broke the camel's back. It cost him his marriage.
As early reports stated that Kim wanted full and complete custody of their kids, but Kanye was not going to let that happen, and rumors of a brutal custody battle started to rise. Also, it was reported by many that Kim was wanting to file for divorce because she wanted the premiere for the final season of her family show, Keeping Up with the Kardashians, to air and showcase the film's spots of her dealing with her upcoming divorce from Kanye before doing the deed. So, given all of that, number 5, why file now? That's a good question, because as all indications pointed to, Kim wanted to wait until her show debuted before officially committing to the divorce filing. But one source close to her notes that apparently she had a change of heart. The insider explains, Kim was just tired of waiting. She tried to give it a chance. She wanted to do this last year. She gave it plenty of time, but it's just time to move on. And before you start thinking of those Jeffree Star rumors, think again. Adds the insider, there were no affairs. No one did anything bad. They grew apart.
A source tells ET that the reality star feels like, quote, there is a weight lifted off her shoulders after officially filing for divorce from Kanye West last Friday.
A second insider notes Kim is definitely sad, but she feels confident in her decision to divorce him because she knows it's what's best for herself and her family. She's already felt like she's been divorced for months now. The source shares, it's been a long time coming and she feels relieved to be able to finally move on. Whether or not that's true is not the issue. What matters is that the divorce is real. And it's happening now. Though another aspect of this sudden filing is that Kanye was rumored to be up for filing before Kim because he didn't want to wait anymore either. Given all the sources and reports, it's hard to tell true fact from fiction, but in the end, the result is the same. Number 4, Kanye's thoughts. Obviously, this can't just be viewed from the perspective of Kim K, as she's not the only one in this relationship. Kanye West is very much the reason that the marriage fell apart, kind of a contrast from it started if you really think about it. And so, knowing that he's losing his wife of 7 years, what does he think about all this? Amid the divorce news, West has been texting people and talking things through, a source tells People. He's in a place of if only.
A source tells ET Kanye is upset that it didn't work out and it will take him some time to adjust to his new normal,
says the source. If only I had done this, if only I hadn't done that. He's processing things. He thinks that the presidential run was the straw that broke the camel's back, the source adds. Before that, there was hope. After that, none. It cost him his marriage. He's likely not wrong about that, as sources close to Kim noted that same issue. Kanye West ran for president in 2020 in a last-minute campaign that literally went nowhere other than to prove just how broken Kanye's mind was due to his bipolar disorder, because not only did he admit to running just to take votes away from Joe Biden, but also he said very racist remarks at rallies, and not the ones you're thinking of. He revealed some very private details about Kim and Kanye's struggle with Kim's first pregnancy, and arguably worst of all, he accused mother-in-law Kris Jenner of being a tyrant and trying to take his kids away from him. So yeah, that's a good place to say that Kim finally had enough. Though to be honest, there was a lot more going on. Number 3. Two people, two styles of parenting. The other major issue that is constantly referenced is that Kim and Kanye had vastly different ideas on how to raise their children, which came out more and more as the rumors of divorce spread. But it wasn't a recent issue either, it's one that's been known about for a while, especially as Kanye's mental state deteriorated. For example, listen to how many kids Kanye wanted. "I want 7 kids. The richest thing that you can have is as many children as possible," which was in direct conflict with Kim in various ways, not the least of which was that because of a health condition, she had to use surrogates for 2 of her children. Plus, she's honestly the one doing most of the work. "Being a mom of 4 is definitely really hectic, but it feels so complete. I'm obsessed with my kids. I'm obsessed with being a mom of 4," she added. "I'm definitely done though, and feel 4 is my limit. I believe that everyone needs so much attention, and I need to be able to give it to everyone." Then there was the location of raising. A while back, Kanye West bought a ranch in Wyoming, and Kim even noted at the time that his dream was to go and raise everyone there in a much simpler life. But she wanted to be in LA because that's all she's ever known.
ET source says that the split has been in the works for a while now, adding that the reality star spent time with her family in Palm Springs, California after filing.
Things got even weirder though when divorce rumors popped up, because then it was revealed that Kanye wanted to take the kids and Kim to live in a compound outside of LA because he felt the city was too fake. So yeah, a lot of differences there. But now that the divorce is filed, things seem to be getting back to a more balanced position. Both of them want nothing but the best for the kids. They want the kids to be happy. The kids will stay with Kim, but Kanye will be able to see them whenever he wants to. They will work out a schedule that is good for everyone. Number 2, are the kids all right? Pretty much all reports from both sides of the equation state that one of the biggest reasons for Kim wanting to divorce Kanye was to protect the kids and make sure they were raised in a certain way that would definitely conflict with Kanye's. However, a key issue brought up was, would they even understand what's going on? Well, yes and no. North has some understanding of what's going on, a source notes, but mostly the kids have always seen them apart, so it isn't super surprising. A separate source close to Kim exclusively tells E! News, Kim expressed to the kids that she loves their dad, but they need to be apart. They don't fully understand what's going on and are already used to the situation.
Another source tells us the couple has been done for a while and have been amicable for a while. At the end of the day, Kanye and Kim love each other immensely, but knew it was time to call it quits.
While it may sound cold, Kim is doing what's right for the children on certain levels, because Kanye's bipolar disorder that he refuses to get treated makes him a danger to not just himself and Kim, but the kids. He might be even keel one day and want to raise them in Wyoming, but then a switch flips and suddenly he wants to take them to a desert compound. Kim couldn't risk that happening and the kids being hurt as a result. But as said reports are stating, Kanye will have access to the kids whenever he wants, so it won't necessarily be a restrictive kind of divorce. Or at least that's not what's being put out there right now. But again, with these two, anything can change on a whim. Number 1, so what happens now? That question is one that is a bit tricky to answer, because while things do seem in a place for smooth divorce proceeding, anything can happen to change that. In terms of the immediateness of things, nothing will happen overtly. There will be meetings and discussions about how to do the divorce and separation, and how to divide up certain property and such, what to do with real estate, money, and so on. Then they'll likely focus on the kids more than likely, and eventually the divorce will be sealed.
We're told Kim is asking for joint legal and physical custody of their 4 children. Kanye is fine with that.
Now, as a certain rapper showed last year, you can file for divorce and rescind it. Will that happen here? More than likely not, as both sides are done, reportedly. But until everything is signed and sealed, we can only wait and hope that no big curveballs are thrown. So what do you think of this look at the divorce of Kim Kardashian and Kanye West? Are you glad that the filing has finally come? Do you think that this amicable agreement between them will actually hold? Or do you think that when push comes to shove, Kanye will fracture from the plan and lead things to a bitter battle? Go ahead and let me know what you think in the comments down below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.